So this presentation is about systematic absences illustrated with a 2D lattice. So this is the aim of the presentation, understanding systematic absences in diffraction peaks and what causes them. I assume you already know what reciprocal lattices are and what it means for diffraction. We will also use the structure factor and selection rules for cubic systems. So this is our 2D lattice. It's a square lattice. So we can define a unit cell like this with these two vectors in red. We could also imagine that we consider this crystal to be made of a centered square lattice. So in this case, we would have this unit cell. This is not now a primitive cell because it includes two points inside this cell. So we have the four here, which contribute one quarter each, so it's one, plus this one at the center. So it's a centered cell, conventional cell. So let's see. So this cell can be thought of as in fact a square lattice with the two vectors, primitive vectors in blue, and a basis of two points. So basis would be this one at the origin and this one at the center. So in fact we would have this would be a point for this lattice, this one also, this one also, this one also, but this is not a lattice point. Okay, it's a point of the basis. So let's see now. So it is a point in the question 3 here. What do we find as reciprocal lattice in these two cases? So here we have represented again the unit cell of the direct lattice, that is constant A, and the lattice, the unit cell for the centered cell. Okay. So here B is larger than A, so we expect the reciprocal lattice for this square lattice to be to have more points than this one. So let's see that. This is the reciprocal lattice, not to scale, for the square direct lattice. Okay, this is the one we get for using this unit cell. So it's larger than this one. That is constant is larger, therefore we have a shorter distance here in the reciprocal lattice. Okay. Also it is rotated of 45 degrees compared to this one. So here we have a nice square in the same way as this cell. Here it is also in the same way as this cell, but smaller. Okay, it is this one. Alright, so also from the geometry of the problem you realize that this distance is the same as this one. So if we compare these two reciprocal lattices, which are different, we just have additional points in this one. This one, this one, this one, this one, for example. So you remember that the reciprocal lattice shows the peaks, the diffraction peaks in reciprocal space. So why do you have we have more points? Because when we do the diffraction, the experiment, we should find only a set of peaks and that's it. It does not depend on our choice of unit cell. Okay, so to come to the rescue, we look at selection rules. You know that for the simple cubic, we get peaks for all the points. So S is equal to F form factor for all H and K, and L, if it were a cubic unit cell, this is 2D, so we drop the L, we just have H and K. Okay, So what about this one? Remember, this is so in fact we have a centered cell. Okay, this is square, but there is an additional point in the center. So it's like the equivalent in 3D is a body-centered cubic. So we look at the selection rules for the body-centered cubic. And here they are. So we have a peak indeed when h plus k is even and zero if h plus k is odd. So let's see what h plus k odd means. So for example, 1 and 0. 1 and 0 mean is here, this point. So this is going to be 0. Then you have of course all the minus 1, 0, 0, 1, etc. So all these four points will be 0. So when you take this into consideration, you do find the same peaks in both cases, which makes sense because again the measurement does not mind which cell, which unit cell you have chosen. Okay, so why do we have extinctions, systematic absences in this case? Well, this is because for these dots, you in fact have destructive interference within the unit cell. So remember, your unit cell has two dots. It has one, let's say, at the origin here and one at the center. So these two interfere with each other destructively for the at these points. Alright, so this explains why you have zero for these points. And this is found in all so-called centered cell. It makes sense because the distance, for example, between this line and this line, then if you take one at the center, it will go through that additional point, and you will have destructive interference between this one and this one, for example, for something considering these lines. Okay. The, for example, the 0, 1 lines. Alright, so I hope this was a good explanation. Okay, so thank you for your attention. I hope it helps.